We want to graph the exponential function y equals 2 raised to the power of x and the log function y equals log base 2 of x on the same coordinate plane. And then we'll discuss the relationship between the two functions. To graph these functions, we'll graph them by hand by completing a table of values. So for y equals 2 raised to the power of x, notice how I've already selected x values. Now we'll perform substitution to determine the corresponding y value. So when x is equal to 0, y is equal to 2 raised to the power of 0. Anything raised to the power of 0 is equal to 1, so y is equal to 1. When x is equal to 1, y is equal to 2 to the first, or 2. When x is equal to 2, y is equal to 2 to the second power, or 2 squared, which is equal to 4. When x is 3, y is equal to 2 to the third, which is equal to 8. And notice I also selected two negative values for x. When x is equal to negative 1, we would have y equals 2 raised to the power of negative 1, which would be 1 over 2 to the first, or just 1 half. When x is negative 2, y is equal to 2 to the negative 2, which is equal to 1 over 2 squared, which would be 1 fourth. Let's go ahead and plot these points on the coordinate plane and sketch our graph. And we'll sketch the exponential function in blue. So we have the point 0, 1, which is the y-intercept. We have the point 1, 2, point 2, 4, point 3, 8, negative 1, 1 half, which would be here, and negative 2, 1 fourth, which would be here. So our function looks something like this. Notice how we have exponential growth because the base is greater than 1. We have a horizontal asymptote along the x-axis, or y equals 0. Notice the domain, or all possible values of x, would be all real numbers. But the range, or the y values, would be y is always greater than 0 because the function is always above the x-axis. Now to sketch the log function, we're going to rewrite this in exponential form. Remember, y equals log base 2 of x is equivalent to 2 raised to the power of y must equal x. So to complete a table of values for a log function, it's easier to rewrite it as an exponential function, and then instead of selecting x values, we select y values and then determine the value of x. But before we do this, notice this equation here and this equation here look very similar, except the x and y variables have been interchanged. So because y is now the exponent, we'll select y values and determine x. Notice how these y values here are the same as the x values we had here for the exponential function. So when y is equal to 0, we have 2 to the 0 equals x, so x is 1. When y is 1, 2 to the first equals x, which is 2. When y is 2, 2 squared, x would be 4. When y is 3, 2 to the third equals x, or 8 equals x. When y equals negative 1, we'd have 2 to the negative 1 equals x, which is 1 half. And when y is negative 2, we'd have y to the negative 2 equals x, which is 1 fourth. Now let's go ahead and sketch the log function in red. So we have the point 1, 0, or the x-intercept, 2, 1, 4, 2, and 8, 3, as well as 1 half, negative 1, and 1 fourth, negative 2. So our log function looks something like this. Now there are several things to notice about this function. The log function has a vertical asymptote, which should be the y-axis with the vertical line x equals 0. Notice the domain of this function would be x greater than 0. And the range of this function would actually be all reals because this function goes down forever as well as goes up forever. Now if we compare these two functions, notice how, looking at the table of values, notice how the x and y coordinates have been interchanged. as well as when both equations are written in exponential form. Notice how the exponential function has a horizontal asymptote of y equals 0, the log function has a vertical asymptote of x equals 0, and notice how the domain and range have also been interchanged between the two functions. So we should recognize that these two functions are inverses of one another. Another way to show that these two functions are inverses is to graph the line y equals x and show these two functions are symmetrical across this line. Well, this line has a y-intercept of 0 and a slope of 1. So it would pass through these points here and look something like this. So notice if we folded these two functions across this line, they would match up perfectly, again showing they are inverses of one another. Okay, I hope you found this video helpful.